Hi, this is Mama Shan with another video tutorial on hair. And picking up where we left off, we had selected some good areas of the hair with the lasso tool and jumped them to new layers, added layer masking using a soft airbrush to brush away the edges. So we have a before and after. We're going to continue this and finesse it a bit by adding yet another new layer where we're going to use the clone stamp tool. So select that from your toolbar, normal blending mode, use an airbrush, soft round, opacity 100, flow 100. You don't need to have a line check. For sample, use current and below, or all layers, depending on what version you're in. But we are going to clone some of these other areas by brushing it. You have to source a point, so hold down your Alt key on a PC or Option on a Mac and click a good area of hair that doesn't have a gap in it. So just click and then release both the mouse and the Alt or Option key and then move directly over to the area you want to start brushing. Keep your mouse held down. The crosshair is indicating where it's sourcing from, so be aware of that crosshair, because if it goes into an area you don't want, that is also going to be cloned. And if you don't source again, it will jump back to that origin point, which is good, save some time, without having that align checkbox on in the top options bar. And that's how I usually use it, because as long as you hold your mouse down, it's aligned, that crosshair is following. When you release without that checked, it's going to jump back to that origin point. Come over here, source this bit of hair right here, release, and then come in here and drag, watching that crosshair to add a little bit more into that area. Using the clone stamp tool, you might see an apparent pattern start to appear. So you can switch to the regular healing brush tool, normal blending mode, sampled, current and below. I tend to use my healing brush using an elliptical shape, which you can change by clicking up here in the options bar, changing your roundness to 50%, and then swinging your angle of the brush according to where you are going to be brushing. Again, you have to source with this by Alt-Option clicking, and then just rub out those apparent areas of stippling patterns that can occur. The healing brush preserves some of the texture, but blends with the existing pixels that are below it. Do something like that. With the healing brush selected too, you want to zoom in and look at some of the areas where your patch was, because oftentimes those areas need a little blending too, a little help. And you can just run along those and they'll blend in a little bit better. Zoom out, control minus. So before and after there. We also, when you're doing hair patching, take into consideration the original image and where the highlights were. I'm going to Alt-Option click on this. And you can see they start down here and kind of go upwards. And the patching process has hidden some of those highlights that should naturally flow this way. So I'm going to turn this back on. There's several ways you can add a highlight, but let's just add a levels adjustment layer. So I'll click on the black and white icon and choose levels. And we want to make it lighter, so take the gamma slider and move it upwards a bit. Maybe the white point sliders to the left as well. Click OK and then invert the mask by pressing Control-I on a PC, Command-I on a Macintosh. Now with white as the foreground color, choosing an airbrush, we can paint in a highlight and sort of make it a cone shape where it's a little wider at the bottom and getting narrower at the top. Further adjust it by changing the blending mode if you need it a little bit brighter. Experiment with some of these. Color dodge is definitely not a good choice, but we can go to screen and then lower the opacity, and that gives us a little bit more brightness. Put that at about 70%, and double click back on the adjustment. You have to use your eyes to analyze certain casts that are in the shadow area. It looks a little rosy to me, so I'm going to just go into the red channel, red for rosy, and introduce a tiny bit of red into that highlight by moving that gamma slider to the left. Click OK. Then I'm going to come back out here with masking, switch my foreground to black, and kind of fine-tune that highlight here and remove it from the existing highlight so that the one we put in blends better. We don't need to make that other one brighter. And I'm going to add another levels adjustment layer for darkening. Click on levels and take the gamma slider to darken and move it to the right just a little bit and click OK. And then again, we're going to invert that with a Control-I on a PC, Command-I on a Macintosh. Switch to white as the foreground to reveal that darkening because I'm just trying to fine-tune that highlight. And change the blending mode to darken, see if that helps, or multiply. Lower the opacity a bit. Okay. What I want to do here is darken this one little area here. These situations come up according to the image. So these are just showing you some techniques that you can use when you notice these things. I'm going to create a blank layer in between this darkening level up here. I'm going to turn that off, in fact, and just create a blank layer and get with my brush. I'm going to sample a nearby color over here, maybe this medium brown. I'm going to paint it over this area. I'm going to change the blending mode to darken and lower the opacity a bit, and then turn this back on to see if that does look better. So you got rid of that one little frayed area. So play with your blending modes and opacities to get the type of thing that you want. Now this is our lightning levels layer. I'm going to come back in here with a smaller brush to just bring that up again, reveal that highlight. X key, that's an existing one. I'm going to extend it out maybe like this. You can kind of see how it looks like a cone. It starts out a little wider at the base, and then it's getting narrower as it's going up. So you just have to play with it till it gets a look that you like. And that looks good. Okay, now I'm going to merge some of these layers. As you add layers to your file, you'll notice down here in the document status bar that it gets bigger. So if you want to free up some of your RAM, your random access memory, so things work a little quicker, you can merge layers as you go. Now I want to preserve my background layer in order to show you a before and after, and you may want to preserve all your layers just to have as reference to read them. But this is a copy file to begin with, so I know I'm not overwriting my original file. This is my edited file. But I'm going to highlight the very top layer and then come down here holding shift down to the hair patch one layer. And when I do this, I'm going to merge them all into one layer without preserving any of these working layers. But I am preserving the background layer because I don't have that highlighted. If you go to the Layers Palette flyout menu, you can see a command for Merge Layers, and that's going to merge the selected layers. If you're in previous versions of Photoshop, you'll want to link these layers and then use the command that you find in here. Now when I do that, it kind of changed the appearance out here. And that is a phenomenon that happens when you have a group of layers and some of them use various blending modes. So I'm going to undo that and show you how to get it to look just like you see it here. And we'll do that simply by clicking on the new layer icon. And all we have to do is go select all. There's a couple of ways you can do this. This is one. So we select all, and then we say edit, copy merged, and then we go edit, paste. And it's going to paste into that blank layer. And you can see when I shut the visibility on and off, there is no change in that. It has taken a picture of it and pasted it there using the blending modes. Now we can come back and click, shift click, and drag all these to the trash. And we have simple two layers. It's reduced our working file size. So we have a before and after. So at this point, I had a question for cleaning up stray hairs. And it's quite easy to do on this image because it's a solid color background. What you do is just create a new layer with an airbrush again. You want to Alt or Option click on the background color and start out by lowering your opacity of your airbrush and just start painting away. You don't want to get too perfect around the hair. Leave a couple of little strays so it looks real. But we can get rid of this mess down here just by painting over it a couple of times. Now the interior, it's a little different. In that, we'll create a new layer and we'll try the spot healing brush. If you don't have the spot healing brush, you can use the regular healing brush with the sample all layers option checked. And we're going to come in here and make the diameter of our brush so that it extends to some of the area that's in proximity to the area we're going to heal. I have proximity match checked up here, normal blending mode. And sample all layers and just drag a little bit and release. And you can see what this does is eliminates the Option Alt Source step that is used in the healing and clone stamp tools. But sometimes it doesn't work like that. That's still left a little bit of a line there. I'll try increasing the diameter a bit and putting the hair in the middle and dragging a little bit. And that got rid of it. And we'll come over here to the side hair and do the same thing. Just drag up. It turns dark, but when you release, it blends that area in. It clones the proximity in over the area that you're brushing that is different. Up here under the brow, click and release, click and release. You just want to make sure when you're doing this, it's preserving the texture. Now this created a little smear, so the handy Control Z on a PC, Command Z on a Macintosh to undo it. You might can try again with this tool, or you can go get your healing brush tool. And I'm going to go in here and just switch that angle a little bit. Make it a little smaller. Source this area right here and come in, click and release, click that area. Now, I want to show you something here. Say I source this area right up here near the brow, but I start down here away from the brow and move upward. Look where the crosshair is. And when I release, it left like a little smudge, but didn't get the color. That's the nature of the healing brush. It'll do some of the texture, but it'll blend with the color beneath it. Whereas if I had used this clone stamp tool and done the same thing, let me make that a little bit smaller, and source up here close to the brow and come down here, it's going to actually source it without a blend. So just be aware of the properties of these tools and use them in combination with one another. So now I'm going to zoom out, and all of these are in normal blending mode, so I will be able to highlight them all and do a simple Control E to merge them without any change in the appearance. It's only when they have blending modes that you have to do that other method. So there we have a before and after. One more detail that you might want to do is a sharpening on this, just to pop that highlight a bit. So let's do a Control J for copy. Then we're going to come in here, Image, Adjustments, Desaturate, Filter, Other, High Pass at 10, change the blending mode to overlay, add the mask, holding down Alt or Option so it's a hide all mask, and with a regular airbrush, white as the foreground, brush in some of this for detail here. You might want to add a little on the earrings too, maybe on the lips. And experiment with the blending modes. Overlay, soft light's going to be too soft. Try hard light, that pops it up a bit. Vivid light, and linear light. I think I'm going to go with vivid light. There's before, and there's after. And that's about it for this hair image. We'll Alt-Option click on the background to turn these layers off, to look at the before image that had the gaps in the hair, the stray hairs out here, and the stray hairs on the face, and Alt-Option click to show the after.